Well, hello everyone. Welcome back to my channel, my 9+10 Shopping Garage. I am Mike. Hope everyone's having a safe, great, blessed 4th of July of 2022. I am. Hope you're doing the same. Now, today we're going to do the top reader hose, change over from the basic black hose to a clearer hose. It's a personal preference, but this video might interest you in how do I do this, or if you want to do it. So, and welcome back to my channel. Excuse me, if you haven't done so yet, I hope you do. Please subscribe and notification bell, and you're up to speed. I've got 179 or 181 vids up now, and I hope all of them's helping you out and entertaining. So first of all, we're going to get ready to drain enough antifreeze to get the top hose off, and we'll go from there. So I'm going to do my best without sweating myself into a puddle to show you how I do this step by step, of course. And excuse the background noise with the traffic, but it's the 4th of July holiday. You got to expect this. So I'm going to tilt this down a bit and show you all that I can. Let me get this turned around a bit and show you a little bit more detail. Okay. Down in there, if I can get spotted, is the drain cock plug for the antifreeze on the radiator. But first of all, okay, I disconnected the battery. I take this hose clamp loose, that bolt out, and take my wiring piece here, solder for my filter, and disconnect the S airflow sensor, and the bigger part of the video starts. So, and actually, there's a top hose, but I'll get this air tube off so we can get a little bit better view of what we're getting ready to do. Ted Mill, let's get started. Let's make sure the video's on. Okay. Hope the long distance you can see this. It's that 10 mil boat I showed you. It's going to take a minute or two to get this job accomplished. Okay. As you can see, up top of the motor, the air tube is moved out of the way. Okay, we're going to go to the car and I'll show you the drainage system. Before I go under it, I just wanted to show you. This is the hose we replaced, and this is the newer type of upper hose, radiator hose bracket I made out of solder, of course. And it's all holding good. Okie dokie. Trying to keep my hands out of the way, and that's not so easy. Okay, under we go. Oh, all right. Antifreeze will be coming from this, which is the bracket for the radiator. And that light off? Well, maybe not. Let's get it started and we'll go from there. Let's get her pretty well figured out here. Lined up. Well, now the... So the starts coming out, we'll see how on target I am. Hopefully dead on it. And I reached my hand down in here. Gotta be a contortionist for this. Down in there you'll feel the T-nut and so far, sounds good. Let's see what we got. All right. Sorry about the camera being jostled around a bit, but I'll do what I gotta do to do this. We'll drain hopefully just enough to do this. And then tomorrow, on the 4th, I will perk the system, which is the video on that too. Lights out. Camera's still rolling. Okay. With a pair of channel locks and a little bit of finesse and being a contortionist, I got the upper radiator hose off. As you can see. Without taking off the bumper guard. Or cover, should I say. And that's about all the antifreeze that came out. Yay. And there's the hose. We have a shortcut, but it's a doozy. If you really want to call it a shortcut. Oh. And that hose is the way I have it set up now. Works like a dream. So I'll tell you the shop and I'll show you one thing I've made. I got to make another one. That's what you're going to see me do. Okay, here we are in the shop, and yeah, if you remember prior videos of the radiator swap out, this is the new hose which I want to cut. And if this doesn't read backwards, it probably will, of course it does. I'm going to give you all the info on this that I've got. And by the way, here is the first piece I've made. I just call it oversized nipple. We're gonna make one and have one at each end. It's made out of shock material, like tubing. And there you are. Bottom part of a white shock and the top part of another shock. This is all made out of shock tubing material. I've spot welded, filed all down, everything fits good. A bit snug, but good, but that's what we want. And give you an idea right now of it. It's gonna be a bit of a snug fit even going into this, but it's what it's gonna take to do it. You want a tight fit. I won't expect it to be quite this tight. Let me give you some more information here. And here it is. That's the info you need for the hose if you're just gonna swap out the direct fit hose. Now, if you get to see me gap this, hopefully my big carcass won't be in the way too much. Time for the goggles, and let's and it gaps. Whoops, hold on a minute. Got ahead of myself. I'm gonna need more water to cool off with something. Let's go get a drink. Okay. Yeah. You want a finishing stone on a grinder to do this. Gonna keep trying to fit it. We got a ways to go. Approximately a quarter inch. Back and forth, like playing tennis. A little more of your thumb. If not, got it. Travels. Warm my thumb. Once you start getting a snug fit, you know you got it. We got over here. Okay. How many burrs that are left on? Need to get them off. Don't take much. Feels good. Little bit of a touch up, be right back. should do it. Throttle back off. Think I've got it. Smaller clamp. Keep the cap up the top and see what's going on. I'm gonna try something a little different than this C-clamp. I remember correctly. Well, I probably got it buried somewhere. Ah, there we are. Okay. Small bony pliers. Whatever it takes to get the job done here, that's what I do. I pre-bend a little bit by my hand to see how close that gap up and... Okay. So I gotta scoot it up just a wee bit. Still just a wee bit. Okay. All right. Okay, that's a pre-fit. That part there is good. Now what I gotta do gotta get it cleaned off now so I can get a ground out of it. I wonder. I want to check into something here in a minute. Oh, I found my pliers right under my nose. Ah. And we'll use them next time. Give me a sec. Brush is a bit rusty, so back to the goggles. Just don't press this too tight and bend a pipe, we're in trouble. Gotta make sure the ground's good. Water's not gonna do squat with the bad ground. That should do it. We're still around. Yay. Okie dokie. Try it without this time. Okay. Now, if I missed part of this, or you missed part of it, that's going to go in the video. Old retired drag racers, they went to machine shop work for the most part. And you pay for the experience because they've already been through it. They know what's going on. The reason why custom work is so expensive. Or any kind of machine work, but the custom is more expensive. Just ask any of the guys that does custom work on anything. Body work, frame, whatever. tweaking it a bit. Okay. Give me a second, we'll hook the welder off and get this end done. Here comes the hot process of it. Oh, because I don't want flash burn. I've had it years ago. It won't feel any better now than it did back then. Way back then. I was probably 20 at the time, and I'm 62 now. Whew! Okay. I gotta do something about this welding helmet. It does not want to stay. The lids don't want to stay where I want it to. Recheck. However many spot welds you figure you know what I need, that's what you need to do. I almost forgot to change my shoes. Now you see why it takes so long doing custom work. There's a lot of process going on with this. Okay, that's one spot, of course. I'm going to kick the helmet. If we go any further, well, I'm gonna try some, see if it works for the first time. Welder off for now. I gotta cut that ring down just a wee bit more. For my satisfaction, anyway. What I thought. Okie dokie. I get myself. Well, let's see what I've got. That's a whole lot better. And let's recheck this. Buck and a quarter, inch and a quarter, same thing. Okay. All right. Motor back on. Everything, the lowest setting other than the wire feed, which is set at 20 per inch, or foot, excuse me. Oh, look at sweet. Everything gets piled on top of each other. More fireworks. Fortunately, I don't see any, but I can hear them. I was going to show you, but yeah. Okay. Good enough. Okay. First and foremost now, did have it aimed down, blowing up. See that, did I? We're going to see that. Sorry about that. We'll get it now. All an inch and a quarter, and it's round. No offset, and we're going to tack up the split or the gap. This may help grab the water man without the gloves. As you can see, it's tacked. They ought to be evenly spaced, long as it's tacked there. Now, a small brush, clean up the welds. Well, slag. That's all the welding for now on this. All I gotta do now is trim them down. I hear the fireworks, but I still don't see any. If I can, I'll give you a treat and show you some. I can see what direction they're coming from. Still need that for, well, yeah, for later. Okay, where's my little treats at? There we go. And that's not it. Where might it be at? That's it. Give me a second here. And little sanding collars to 120 grit. You're probably hearing them, the fireworks. I just don't see them. But we just had some of our own fireworks with me spot welding. Tack welding, however you want to call it. Okay, now I got to find what I had earlier. But I placed somewhere now. There it is. Small screwdriver time. Let's get one of these on here. Apparently these are bare to change. Wow. Okay. Needle nose and see what I can do. Well, shoot. I'm trying to hold on to these darn things. Needle nose is too big. Let me get a smaller pair. But these razor change beers back. Wow. Okay. Well, but on these when it came off, that's a plus. Not so hard on the ears, but just a case on the eyes on my glasses. Okay. Oh, by the way. To make it easier for the hose to fit on this, on each one, you need to chamfer or bevel the edges of the collar or the flange. Bevel the best you can. Feels good. I do want to bring your attention to something here. It's going to be up to your decision. These dark spots are low spots. But you need to take them up, file all that down to get to that. That's up to you. But I feel nothing, but there's an indentation there. I'm not going to. Doesn't feel right, work with it. Work on it. Whatever needs you need to change out to keep the job going good is what you need to do. This is only my second one in two pieces. Feels good. Looks good. Okay. One end finished. All feels smooth, no catches, bare fingers, as you can see. All looks good. Yay. Welder off. Goggles back on, and I still don't see the fireworks. Well, darn it, darn it, darn it. And this piece right here, you see, goes to my bench press. That's what I unhooked. Okay. I got it. Thank you. at that guy. Oh, time to let my eyes breathe. Looking good. Okay. Just getting the burrs away from the fingers. Good enough. Okay. Do it. Take a look-see here. That does it. Almost on my foot. Yeah. Okay. Back to these. Connection time. All for this. And the same process all over again. And we've been at this now just over an hour. Feels good. I'm gonna try a little bit different method. Whoops, still disconnected. Oh, you plugged up the same one I just had?
Well, what is using?
There we go. That's better use of the file. See, live and learn, and by experience. Thank you. King Kong would be proud of me. Look what a job, what a ring that is. Oh, yes, indeed. For the most part, right at a quarter. What the doctor ordered. Where's my seam at? There it is. Time to mark it and cut. Yeah, still some ways, some things I have to do the hard way. I ain't got a full machine shop. It's just my little shop. But for the most part, I can do what I want. Not running a business. Can't bend pipe. Can't put a car up on a rack. Or a truck. But I improvise. That's part of life and part of the job. I got enough stuff on the bench. Put my cutter wheel back up, and that part is done. I don't have to get ready to take me a break. My back and legs are giving out on me. But we're into this an hour plus. Hour to 5 minutes. I'm not going to leave y'all hanging. I'm going to finish this up later tonight or tomorrow on the 4th. And a quarter. Almost right on it. I'm impressed. Now the question is now. A little too much. Okay, now to tweak it. Got that. Files down, set it, prep it, and we're gonna be done for a while. Rick, I didn't check it. I knew I didn't have a quarter cut off round off that time. Now we're gonna start checking every time. Just a wee bit more, a little crooked. Feel like I've got it. Give it a look, see what we got. Oh, let my eyes dry out, so. I got a bend in this, I got a... Aha! Be right back.
Thank you.
think I can get it now. Let's see what I can do. I can make this work now. Give me a second, we're gonna try something now. I'm gonna force the gap and that two gaps closed, or at least one of them. I gotta tack it and see what I can do. And back to my shirt, back to the sweat box. Thought the fireworks was over, I still heard popping and cracking, but odd enough, I don't see it. Kick my helmet. Excuse me. Yeah, I'm getting a bit hungry now. Sometimes you run into a snag. And sometimes you don't. Okay. The rig got bent out around. Sometimes it better get you. That's done, it got me. It's all right. We're getting it. Well, this is going to be a touchy one. See what I can do. Doggone it! get that, a little bit of a push would do that, but obviously it will. Well, wasn't quite expecting this, but let's see what I can do this way. Nope, don't like that just yet. Oh, that's a lot better. Oh, yeah. A little bit more touch up. A little more tweaking, fine tuning, as we called it back in the day. That'll do it. Let's tack it. And I'm done for a while. I give out. Sorry. Okay. I'm about done for the night, y'all. I'll fine-tune this tomorrow. We're a buck and a half in time. Not bad. Not that I'm timing it. That just shows me. So hope you didn't miss anything. Hope I didn't miss anything. It caught you up to speed now with this video because I left that recorder off for a bit. So I recapped some of it. So peace out. Stay healthy. Stay safe. Keep the wrenches turning. Easy on the knuckles. Never feels good, and a magnet to pick its heels up off the ground. It happens. And once again, a happy, blessed, and super safe 4th of July of 2022. My Nikon S10 sign off for now, and we'll finish this up tomorrow. And I'm going to try a video to see how long I can pause this without having to make so many videos of steps and make it all into one. That way, you see it all one time, and I can get it done all one time. So we'll give that a try here in the near future. So peace out. Thanks for stopping in and seeing what's going on. And once again, want to reiterate this, thanks so much to my subscribers that subscribe to my channel and staying up to speed with what I do. It's really wholeheartedly appreciated. I hope to get more. I'd like to have more. And I hope all this helps you out. Stay safe, everyone. Have a great one. My Nikon S10, that's all for now. Catch you on the flip side.